Welcome to Ashley's YouTube page. How are you guys doing? I hope you guys are doing all good. I hope you guys are nice. My name is Ashley Tabete. You know the story. I've been here before. I'm here again. And I am so proud of the fact that I'm here for the third time. If you're here for the first time, or the second time, or the third time, it's all good. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, comment, and share this. This past week has been actually a lot of going to back and forth. I was at this university called UCAD, which is the second biggest university around Ireland. And I was there, you know, to, you know, basically just see the campus. And the campus was really dope, you know, they had this whole lake. Anyways, it was a really, really, really great campus. And they had this whole thing about, you know, giving us a tour on VR, which was pretty dope. And I've never, you know, since I came, I actually realized when I was here that I've never ever put my eyes on the VR goggles. And this was the first time that I did, and it was pretty dope, you know. I got to understand how the metaverse is actually, you know, pioneering to make the world digital, which is pretty cool. But also, in a way, I feel like it's a paradigm shift for a lot of people, you know, like, because think about it now, with the VR and AI going up, it means a whole paradigm shift for people who've been, you know, working their lives for the past maybe 20 years. Because I know people who've been always been working as cashier or a, you know, somebody who deals with basically maintaining a machine, you know, and now those machines are able to maintain themselves, you know. Cashiers, like here in Ireland, like I could go shopping and just shop whatever I want to shop and pay without any human supervision on me. So those things were basically what I saw at UCAD, and they showed us a lot of stuff. It was pretty cool to be there. And then after that, you guys remember my last video? My last video, I was out here preaching to you guys about how it's so important to have the relevant documents when you are going somewhere, right? That is what I told you guys, right? And ironically, so you remember I told you about that whole trip that I had to Denmark and Italy and then Poland. So I tried to do a trip, and then when I go to Denmark, I got detained cheap. They had to turn me back because my visa was not valid until the 3rd, and I was traveling when? On the 28th. So I was essentially maybe like 5 days early for the trip. So basically they had to turn me back, but the people there, the cops were okay. They really didn't give me so much trouble. They just told me, man, you're way too early for your visa, so basically we want to keep you in a detention center. It was actually pretty super dope. The whole place was just looking super nice. I could bath, I could eat, I could just sleep. I actually had a Wi-Fi in a detention center. That's actually pretty cool.
Hey guys, I'm back again. It's almost 24 hours since I've been detained here. I even had a whole change of clothes now. So I think they're gonna let me go soon. They're gonna deport me back to Dublin. I spent the whole day and yesterday doing nothing. It really sucks, man. It really sucks. I came all the way just to be locked up in this small space. But with that being said, I'll see you guys back in Dublin. Let's go make some content in Dublin, baby. Ciao.
So after that, I took a flight back to Ireland. They paid for it. It is actually pretty cool. They paid for it. I came back, and then when I came back, I met this guy at the airport when I was waiting for the bus to come to my town, which is Casablanca. I told you guys before on the last video. But so while I was waiting for the bus to come through, I was chilling with this guy, white man, Irish, and he was lit, okay? He was lit at the bus stop. He had a whole bottle of Chardonnay and he was downing it down. Quah, 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 quah. That's when I realized the episode on Irish people. It might not be a lie, okay?
Welcome to Ireland. We'll be landing in 5 minutes.
This is quite a country, Brian. You know, Ireland has more drunks per capita than people.
Oh, that's a negative stereotype. I don't think the Irish drink as much as people say they do.
It might just be true. So yeah, I came back and one of the things that maybe you guys noticed, got a haircut, you know, look all nice. You know, people that know me personally, they know how much I love to have a good haircut, and I couldn't do it for so long because I was really, really, really scared about who's gonna give me a good haircut, you know. And I just took my chances. I went to the nearest barbershop and I was like, hey, could you cut my hair and give me a good haircut? And they were like, hey man, let's try it out. And they gave me this decent haircut and I'm pretty thankful for it. So like I told you, I live in Castle Blaney. One of the places that I went to is, not one of the places that I went to, one of the places that is my favorite place to go to when I come here. When I come here all the time, if I'm free, I definitely want to go to Fox's Den. Fox's Den is such an amazing place. It's just like, I'm a groove astro. If you know me, it's either we met at a groove or we met traveling, right? But most of the people that know me, we met at groove, okay? I know that is the truth because I like grooving. I like having fun, like playing on my piano, playing, you know, the whole thing, going all out, Joe. You know the story. You know the story. It's actually Sylvester out here on this mic. So yeah, Fox's Den. We're talking about that. Fox's Den is pretty dope. I didn't know because I'm from SA. Remember, I told you on the first video that I was filming for Capello. So that's the type of groove lifestyle that I'm used to. I'm really used to like lifestyle whereby like groove is like super intense, you know, like people are going down, you know, like hands are wearing like sexy and stuff, you know what I'm saying? The niggas are out just splurging for the alcohol, they splurging, they're filling up the tables, so you know the story, you know how it goes down. And since we listen to our piano, we're going crazy, we're going hamburger, now we're out here buying bottles, Hennessy's on Hennessy's on Hennessy's. But when I got here, it's actually a different story. I went to Fox's Den one day. When I went to Fox's Den, it's a very small setting, right? It's a very, very, very intimate, private setting. And I got there and I buy a beer and I look around the place. It's really, like I've been emphasizing this so much. It's really small, but it really has everything that you need as a person that wants to meet other people, because it's just a pub, it's not a club, right? I've been in a club here in Ireland, and it's actually next to my house, and it's going down right now. I can literally hear the poof poof poof. But yeah, so with that being said, Fox's Den is really small. It's a really small environment. There's like, you literally, if you go there 2-3 times, you will know everybody that goes in there. And it's a lovely place, you know. They've got pool, which I like. I like playing pool. Anybody that also knows me knows the fact that I will beat you in pool respectably. I'll not take any mercy on you. In Zokshaya, they say in Zulu, I'm gonna kick your ass in English, because I play pool and I play to beat people's ass. Anyways, yeah, there's pool, there's what do you call that game, darts, there's darts and all of that. So it's really been pretty amazing. Today is a Saturday, right? And I'm really feeling vibey. I really want to go out to go and see how it is. I've been at Switch one time. It was pretty, really, really dope. And for those that are here, that for my followers that are Irish, right? Because I know that I do have little bit of Irish people that actually followed me. Thank you guys. I'm gonna shout out to Paul, Megan, Jamal, Alex. Thank you guys for putting up. I'm gonna show you guys a little bit of South African music. How we party. I'm gonna put down a couple of videos of how we actually get down. I'm not